Bazafana chikonko. Nikajionko fe. Teta ali ntiezu za bige. This is Sambalungo. You are watching Rooftop with Ken One.
Healthy, live healthy with Alexa Kombucha. Alexa Kombucha. A magical medicine or naturally carbonated health drink.
Mafiga enu makwata vana mulenga ya ye chiye ye ye. Hi, this is Ponchano Kaiche. You are watching The Rooftop with Ken One.
Booyah! Welcome to The Rooftop with Ken One. I ain't Ken One. It's The Rooftop with Catch One. It's the Coppola invasion, baby. You already know. But yo, don't get surprised. Ken One is still here with me.
It's some kind of a Coppola LSK situation.
You know how we do when we in the building.
So welcome to Lusaka, man.
Yo, thank you for having me.
Welcome on the rooftop.
Yo, my brother.
So we're gonna do this show together as we enjoy the view of LSK City. You understand?
This is like, yo, this is happening. This is real. Live and direct from the rooftop. LSK City, baby. So Ken One.
Yeah.
This is a great show we're doing here, my brother.
Of course, this is the rooftop throwback. Mm-hmm. And of course, we are just getting kick-started like every other time. Uh-huh. Expect nothing but the cream of Zambian music from way back. We throw it way back.
Way back. Okay, speaking of way back, what video are we gonna take? What's our first video that we take way back?
All right, let's go to Sam Peterson. Uh-huh. And this one is entitled Oh No. You remember that?
Oh my goodness, this is the old Peterson. So let's go to that Peterson. Oh No.
Oh no! every single day we try. Vili pose veji jita vili bad. Mafuto every single day we cry. Koma we try.
Oh no.
Sinifuna na gulanga.
Oh no.
Mifuno tako pala mezo yanga.
Oh no.
Alright, Peterson throwing us back right there with a video entitled Oh No. Remember, that is what we do best on the rooftop. Right now we're buzzing on social media, so make use of your phones and go to our Facebook page, which is the Rooftop Throwback. Like the page and let us know from whatever part of the country you're watching at from. Be it Kopala, be it LSK. And remember, today it's a special show because we are hosting it together with Kachinga.
Yeah. Yo, my man, it's an honor for me to be here.
Yeah.
So, my brother, it's good to see how artists have developed over the years. Because look at where Peterson started from, and Peterson that we have now is like
in his dreadlocks.
You know what I mean?
You know what I mean?
And the guy's like not just a Zambian star. Our artists are shining out there as well. So, which is good. And they came a long way.
Yeah.
But anyway, let me not do much talking. Let's get into the video.
You spoke of shining. Talking of shining, our guest today. Ish, the CV is too much.
Yeah, man.
There's a lot to say about this guy. So hence we're gonna prolong the interview. It's going to be a special one. He's done a lot, especially obviously both for the industry and for Zambian hip hop. And speaking of our guest, we will be hosting Slab D, you know, just after this video. We'll get talking to him and find out how his journey of music has been. For now, let's go to his video.
My number one to all the DJs and my friends. One love, Slab D, Slab D.
Simbinza, nenzoona monga vintu siviza sebenza. Maplan na mamuvu yenze ya naimirira. Kuma nenze na mafans ya naimirira. Chilo West kutawama ndi yenze lipo yanga. Ndiye nenzo rekoda hip hop mchinyanja. Kunifaka chimwera slap dindi wechikali. Hosa zirekenera uzaka fika patiari. Yeah. Ninacho ka face promo, kanyimbo katuwana paja ndie yenze demo. Sinezo gani zira kutichinga lide so. Rap mchinyanja inga fike kupa so. Ii nyimbo, ifuna cheni kambeko zikomo. Kulibana nikonda kuyambira chepa promo. Kuchokera kunyasi kwa mutima kulinimwe. Kulibeimwe wantu, nishi kulibeini. Na wajavene wa mafaka manja muamba. Tuni ya wonse wevali befaka lijo. Wajavana ni pasole mbera pozina nyimbo. Ma DJs wapa radio na muma club. Musaka CF muchita guys one love. Monani manja malifiki zapano. Chamene nezo funo kamba cheni zikomo. Pahon, pahot 96.8. Radio form wanipere kako throughout set. Sininga iwareko pari Q na Phoenix. Ndiawandia wanani riza first muma Z mix. Olo nika sign it you na wadresi. Nizaka miibala imwe loko one day. Kuchokera kunyansi kwa mutima kuli imwe. Kulipe imwe wantu, nishi kulipe imwe. That promote me on the streets, all the people that helped me say what zero. I just wanna say thank you. You have my back, I have yours. Let's move. Ain't no room for hating one another. They don't.
Word up.
Let me say thank you to these people. Thrillmatic, Ali, one master, LT, Devin M, Danny Bedo, Lindsay, JT. Rev Dina,
mix master, na bene cash and flex. Sininga yivale ko hip hop DJ Drex.
So you know what? We're full of surprises, and we got Slap D with us on the rooftop today. Hey yo, Slap, King Dizzle. Should I? Let's pay honors. Let's pay homage right way. Yeah. King Dizzle.
That's what's
what
up.
What it do?
What's good, son?
What's up, man?
Maybe you have to go an extra mile. Kneel down. Yeah. King right now.
Yeah. Word.
Yeah.
Okay. So how we doing, my man? It's been 10 years in the game.
10 years in the game. This year makes it 11, actually.
Joe. Okay. So, and the accolades to go with that is crazy.
Yeah, I mean, the shine is out there.
Yeah.
The peeps is loving it.
Yeah.
It's all gravy.
But tell me, how's it been on the journey? I'm sure you've gone through a lot of problems, especially like the beef and everything. How do you manage to stand long like 10 years strong, man?
I mean, obstacles make you stronger.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Fear is there for us to get rid of.
Yeah.
To be faced, it's meant to be faced, and pain is there to keep to make us stronger.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I see those as obstacles that make me stronger, that empower me, make me a better rapper, make me a better musician, and most of all, a better businessman.
Yeah.
Now, and talking about beef, you know, obviously the Kopala LSK thing was just one of those, you know, big things and highly talked about. And, you know, I'm with my own right now, Kachinga. We're talking about LSK City versus Kopala.
Yeah.
Obviously, you know, away from that, I think you've been doing great things, man.
Yeah.
We can tell, obviously, from the accolades, from the so many hit songs. Yeah. But let's take it back, you know, to the first time that you stepped in the studio. Give us a picture. How was it?
It was tense, like any first time. I was nervous. I was shy. I was studio shy, you know, but I really wanted to do it. So I was, you know, hungry at the same time. I wanted to spit bars, but at the same time, I didn't know how to go about it.
Mm-hmm.
So for instance, I made a mistake, like I did a whole take, the whole song in one take.
Mm-hmm.
And so my producer had to advise me and say, look, you can actually break, you know,
and
come back and join your bars after, you know, after breathing.
Mm-hmm.
For me, that was a new thing. All I thought was in a studio, you go one shot, one take, and that's the kill. So it was a great experience, but you learn after a few sessions, you understand, and then it becomes you become a better musician, recording artist. Yeah.
Are there songs that you've done that you wish you never did? Like one of those songs, like, why did I put that out?
Not really.
Uh-huh.
I mean, before I put out a song, I listened to it.
Uh-huh.
Right now I'm playing my own music, BW2 in the car, I'm bumping my own beats.
Yeah.
I go through my music a lot just to make sure it's good and change a few things where I feel, you know, they weren't properly done.
Mm-hmm.
Although I felt like that on a couple of songs, like after it hit radio, I'd be like, what? We should have upped the bass, we should have made the kick louder, you know, we should have did this and that.
Uh-huh.
But there's very few of those because most of the time, we listen to the music. I play it back to back in the car or as I sleep.
And that's one thing I know about you. I know that you're a perfectionist. And this brings me to my next question. How long does it take, you know, for you on average just to have a song out and you're completely satisfied?
The recording process is actually very, it's slow, it's short.
Mm-hmm.
It's, cause I record from the jump. Like when I get in the studio, I like the beat. I get an idea for the hook. For me, it starts with the hook.
That
gives me the theme and concept for the song.
Okay.
The bars are just walkover. I'll be very honest with you. The bars are cake.
That's a rapper right there.
I'm not even bragging when I say I can't remember the last time I wrote a song. The last song I wrote was, I think, Nombanishi.
Okay.
You know what I mean? That's the last song I wrote. But it's the mix down, editing, mastering that takes forever because you can't rush that, you know what I mean?
Sure.
Every song is different in its own way. Some songs have got more bass than others, some have got more highs, some are downbeats, some are upbeats.
And
so it's the mix down that takes a lot of time, and you need to be patient with the producer and also make sure he puts out a good record.
Okay.
Yeah.
And also now, speaking of being 10 years in the game, 10 plus, let's say.
Yeah.
Like, to be relevant for that long, you know, hip-hop, I'm sure, when you started and how the genre is right now, it's shifted. How do you maintain that relevanceness and still be an OG?
It's called evolution, man. Mm-hmm. You need to move with the times.
Okay.
You need to move with what's happening.
Yeah.
You need to keep your ears on the ground.
Yeah.
So basically what that means is, you know, I listen to every rapper out there. I listen to all sorts of music.
Yeah.
I mean, that's one advantage that I have. You know, for me, everything goes as long as it's good music. Sometimes I sit down and play, you know, play a Roomba song just to hear, especially if it's famous and popular.
Yeah.
I want to hear why it's famous, why it's playing, or, you know, why everybody's dancing to it.
Yeah.
And those are some of the tips that I get. Sometimes it's the highs. See, music is not about the rhythm, it's not about the lyrics all the time. Sometimes it's about the dynamics.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? How are the highs? What makes it bump in the... There's music that you play in the club and everyone's dancing.
Or
play it in your car.
It's
just another song.
Okay.
So you need to understand it's the dynamics of the song that make it great. That, you know, in the club and different in a car. So for me, those are the things that I've learned to master and also learn. I've learned to just strengthen my art on those.
Okay.
Yeah.
You've worked with a lot of artists. Obviously, 10 years in the game is not a joke.
Yeah.
But let's bring it down to hip-hop. You know, there's been a lot of talk, obviously, in your song, King. Other people are saying King. Let me put you in the box.
What do you mean other people are saying King? And
like
be specific.
Like in the rap game. Like in
You've
the rap
got
game,
the hammer. Hit it. Hit it.
Okay, let me be straight.
Yeah.
Like, in Zambian hip-hop, everyone else claims to be the King.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, someone... Raf Kaida will say I'm better than Slab D. Makti will say I'm better than Slab D. Let me get it from your own mouth. Why do you think you're better than, or you're bigger than every other Zambian hip hop artist?
Apart from your size.
I don't think that.
You're bigger.
You know what I mean? You, why do I should be saying, why do you think that?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Do you think that yourself? The thing is, look, it's not just Zambia. It's music everywhere, man.
Mm.
In America, they'll say the greatest. I'm the greatest. I'm the greatest.
Yeah.
Best rapper alive. It's,
yeah.
I mean, it's normal.
It's
especially in hip-hop.
Mm.
It's a genre that's very competitive.
True.
But I'll tell you something. King is just a word. You know what I mean? I can say I'm the king of England.
Mm.
I'm the king of...
exactly.
Yeah, I'm the king of, I'm the president. It's a word like president. I can stand up right now and claim myself president of Zambia.
Yeah.
Does that make me a president? No, it doesn't. Because those are just words out of my mouth.
You have to prove
You have to prove it. Exactly. You have to prove why you call yourself king. Through your behavior, through your mentality, through your thinking, through your music. How many number ones have you had?
Yeah.
You know? How many magazine covers have you nailed?
Mm-hmm.
How many albums have you done? You know? How long do you have in the game? You know?
Yeah, true. Okay.
So it's all those things that make you, when I say it's King Dizzle, I'm not saying it as a brag. I'm saying it out of respect for myself. You know what I mean?
Mm.
I'm not asking anybody else to say or to call me that as well. I'm just saying to myself, I'm proud of what I've made.
Yeah.
I'm proud of what I've become. Mm. And I can now call myself King Dizzle.
One thing I want to find out. If I asked you to single out a rapper, you know, Zambian rapper, who would you say is doing well for you?
It's not one rapper. There's a lot of rappers that are...
Apart from XYZ rappers, outside XYZ, who would you say you're very impressed?
Like I said, there's a lot of rappers out there. I'm impressed with lots of rap music that's coming out right now. If I said one rapper is doing well, it would be very unfair to the other rappers.
That's a smart answer.
I'm telling you, there's about 10 rappers that I'm feeling right now.
Zambian
rap, hip-hop,
you
know, artists that I'm feeling right now. Some underground, some you've never heard of.
Yeah.
So even if I pointed them out, I don't think it would do any good. All in all, hip hop is doing bars. People are coming up, and from the top of my head right now, I could.
Kachinga maybe.
Yeah, see, that's the thing. Kachinga is doing good things, though I haven't heard a song from him in a while.
Listen to that, yeah.
I haven't heard a song from him in a long while. But I mean, there's lots of rappers out there in the hood that are doing big things, you know?
Yeah. All right, we're having fun. We are on the rooftop, and this is the Rooftop Throwback. And remember, we throw you back to the early days of Zambian music. And right now, we're just about talking to Slab T about his early days of his career. And me and Kachinga, including the King, we're hanging out from here. It's drizzling, but yeah, that's what we do best on the rooftop. Kachinga, have you ever been to his home?
Not yet. So are we going from here?
Come?
Yeah. No, let me surprise you. I've been there already.
Okay. Oh, have you?
Yeah.
See, have you invited?
It's on camera already.
So, okay.
Let me do this for your sake. Let me just show you a snippet of what his home looks like.
Okay.
You know, it's a king's home.
Yeah. That's it's a palace. Yeah.
All right. So for now, let's check it out.
What's up? My name is Slab D. Welcome to my crib. Yeah. Yeah, so come in, man. This is my crib. This is where I relax from. This is basically where I chill and, you know, spend my time with my daughter and my boo-boo. Yeah. Out here is my awards. These are my awards. My 9-0 mix. Best male artist, best male hip hop, 2015, best collaboration, my homeboy, my little brother, Ralph K.I. Best male contemporary song of the year, that was Quick Child. And over here, I've got obviously my number one position, the only rapper with this in Zambia. You need to know that. Slap Goma. Rappers, you need to learn from JJ. And up here, honestly, up here was my first ever Born and Bred Award. Shout out Smooth IK, shout out ZNBC. That's my 2010 Born and Bred Best Hip Hop Music Video. Over here is my baby girl, my princess, Princess Nandi. Nandi, love her to death. Black. Very basic, only not dialect. Honestly, this cannot miss in the crib. Usually I'm relaxing in one of these champagne. I've got lots of these shots for whenever I'm chilling. Let's come here after a long day, get some short bottles, sit here, kappa. Zambians like to laugh, so they might mock me. One is in pills, the other one, you know, just for again. Yeah, so it's a simple crib for a simple guy. Look at my crib, it's very basic. The numbers in here, pictures of my daughter, cards, calendars of my daughter. My sanctuary is where I do the workout from in the morning. My bench. I come in here, bring back like that, and then take over the world and come out here to have a drink like this, drink some water, and just relax. The sun out there, drawing. I'm just finishing the other building. Two more buildings and you can come back. You can see this is door on the floor. That's showing that this is a typical Nandi room. This is where I do the prayers and bedtime. You know, tell her, give her the body, sleep over, give the kisses, one way out. Welcome to the walk-in closets. Not much to wear, but you know, lots of space. Welcome. We just walk in and walk out. It's called the walk-in closet for a reason. This is the jacket that I wore in Steve's video for Paya. I wore this summer in Queen China. I like to keep a lot of my vintage clothes for my videos. These are some of my jackets. Some stuff that you find in my closet. Work suits. That's because I really don't care how I look sometimes. Not a lot of stuff to use. Basic shoe rack, very, very simple. Now that you check out my crib, I've been here, my name is Slap D, number one hip hop rapper. I've been Zen, I've been Africa, get out of here.
So that's why they call him King Dizzo, hey. King must have his palace, King must be in his kingdom. Whoa, man, wait a minute, one thing that caught my attention. Yeah. Was the trophies, man.
Yeah.
You have more trophies than Man United, bro. Come the on,
only,
take us through. How many trophies is
that?
I like that. I love all the praise, man. I'm loving this right now. You keep coming.
Okay, so like really, bro, take us down the years. Which one was your first award? Like what year was this?
I got more awards, the most awards in 2009.
Yeah.
Well, my favorite awards were in 2009. I was picked to go and represent the region, not just Zambia, the region at the Mamas.
Yeah.
That's one thing most people don't talk about,
yeah.
But that was one of the biggest things, highlights of the year for me. And also that same year, I won Best Male Artist, 2009 Ngoma Awards.
Yeah.
That's a huge one. That's my favorite award because I'm the only rapper with Ngoma.
Yeah.
The first and only rapper with Ngoma to date. Yeah. But hey, awards are just objects, man.
And then there was the night you won how many awards?
I won 6 awards in a night. Yeah, 2013.
Jeez.
That was a great night,
yeah.
Too. Yeah, the
that was good, eh?
Yeah, and then came following year and scooped 3 more awards.
Dope.
Yeah,
okay.
Then 2015, I was like, nah, let's pass it on to someone else on the team. And they
That's
gave
been
it to
they
gave
That's
it, they gave it to Bobby East.
Okay.
So, yeah, we
That's
appreciate
dope.
It.
All right,
yeah.
From your video, what's the title again? Is it Zikomo? Where you were wearing it, is it a
when he was
jumper?
The skinny slap dude.
Yeah. I was reading something on your Facebook from way back where you said you were talking about the video having, you know, I think you got that caught without paying for it.
Yeah.
You remember that post?
Yeah.
When you're here now and you're Slap D, you know, one of the most celebrated Zambian artists, what does it remind you of coming from such a background? What would you tell an artist out there that is in the early stages of their career and pushing hard to be on the level where you're at?
I would say I like to rephrase questions all the time. I would actually say, what would I tell the younger me?
Uh-huh.
Because it's hard to tell another artist what they will go through, because you're not God.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I don't read palms, I don't do none of that. So I wouldn't know what they're going through, and I don't know what drive they have. We have different drive as human beings, you know what I mean? Passion, levels of passion are different. So what would I tell the younger me? I would probably say, don't burn your bridges, first of all. Stay humble. Man, this game is too tiny. You burn one bridge here, you might want to use it tomorrow. You know what I mean? Stay cool with everybody, you know? One of the things that really helped me be here now is the relationship that I had with industry cats. You know what I mean? You might think I have a lot of beef going on, but in the background, I'm really connected to a lot of industry guys. You know what I mean? I'm cool with them, in short. Mm. Why? Because those are my bridges.
Mm.
You don't burn your bridges. If I have a dispute with my industry cats, I mean DJs, I mean background, the guy holding the camera right now, you know what I mean? It's all those people. And it's not just, I don't mean the guy standing here next to me. I mean everyone, the crew. You need to be nice to everyone.
Okay.
I heard someone say, it's nice to be important, but it's important to be nice. You know what I mean?
That's strong.
So first of all, be nice. If you don't want to call it that, say, be humble. Stay real, man. You know, this business comes with a lot of fame, gets your head popping, getting big. So you need to learn to control your fame. You know, when and when not to say what and what not to say.
All right.
Be humble, don't burn your bridges, and stay focused.
All right. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much, King Diesel, you know, for coming on the rooftop.
Yeah.
And this is how we're going to break off from this interview. We're actually winding up on the interview. I know this was not on the script, but I'm prompted to do this. Are you ready for this?
Yeah, yeah. Whatever
it is. We're not catching the camera right now. We're live. Yeah. All right. So I want you to lead us into the break by way of doing a freestyle about the rooftop.
Whoa!
Yeah, camera on him.
Nah, apologies. I don't freestyle anymore. No. I'm sadly, but I could give you a verse from my upcoming album.
Yeah,
BW2. It's one of my favorite verses.
Yeah.
Ish, corona, kweven, kwama, politics. Too many people looking at you, wanting apologies, a necessary drama. Nobody want none of this. Why by kose samongani exam on my colleges? I don't get it. Now I call them jealous. They act like dudes, but they really some Bruce Jenners. Nifuna chechi shawama na hot sauce. Suka nifunsa ni gule chinanguni, of course. Sharp, sharp, like I'm talking about Gillette. I'm really just a fly G, nothing about the jet. You know what they say, what you want is what you get. And right now, I just want one thing, one cigarette.
So that's BW coming. So you know the king.
Yeah.
We saw the palace.
Wait.
Let me get it right. We saw the king's castle.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? So now, King Dizzle, your final words. Shout out to your people.
Shout out to my fans. Shout out to my family. Shout out to all the media houses. Shout out to Kachinga. Shout out to Ken One. Shout out to ZNBC. You've been holding us down since day one. And shout out to the Zambian people for giving a boy from Montero a big chance like this one.
Word.
I'm now a big boy.
Yeah.
Don't sag my pants no more.
Yeah.
I don't sag my pants no more. I wear suits when I'm dressed up.
Yeah.
And yeah, we're here. XYZ forever. Shout one.
So you heard it from the big man, King Dizzle. We're gonna go on a break right now, but catch us on the flip side. It's the rooftop, baby.
Hi. My name is Munyemesha, the CEO for Zambian Film Factory. Here at Zambian Film Factory, we do high quality TV adverts, TV documentaries and TV programs. We also do radio adverts, radio jingles and radio programs. Besides that, at the Zambian Film Factory, we are also specialized in quality musical videos shot in both 4K and Full HD. At Zambian Film Factory, we also do high quality photos, both for studio best and outside, so you know where to go to when it comes to kitchen parties, weddings and other events, including the graduation ceremonies, right here at the Zambian Film Factory. Now time has come for you to make Zambian Film Factory your household name for everything that has to do with picture and sound, and of course media consultancy. So find us at Findeco House, 15th floor, room 9, along Cairo Road, right here in Lusaka. Or give us a call on +26097777744. The Zambian Film Factory, the power to become.
All right, welcome back. This is the rooftop, and that is what we do best. I hope that by now you are making use of your social media. And remember, it's me and Kachinga on the rooftop today, and what a great interview we had with Slabdi. But also, watch out for the challenge. We should be going to the challenge. It's one segment that you have to watch out, the challenge with Slabdi, man.
So now imagine, what do you think
we should do to our next celebrity. You can also hit us up on social media, Facebook. What challenge and which celebrity do you want to see do next? Mm-hmm. But for now, we're going to go check out what King Dizzle got up to.
Yeah, but not just now. You're in a hurry for the challenge,
you,
right?
Bro, I can't wait to show them.
Let's hold it up. So, yeah, you know, for a little bit of time. For now, let's check out another video. This one is coming through from Crisis alongside JK, and it's entitled One Day. Check it out.
Cairo roll, trying to get some money to eat. I used to sell CDs in Soweto Market just to get a little bit of money in my pocket. My shorty had a baby on the way. She used to tell me, like, Chisenga, you a loser. I was like, no way. Every day I was hustling hard, talking to God, thinking, damn, yo, why the hell is life so hard? You never seen my struggle. Where you wake up starving and you know you gotta use every muscle. I've been with the thugs and they know where I came from. That's why they giving me hugs. I got the world on my back, the future in front of me, and a million plus fans that follow me, holla back. I got the world on my back, and the future in front of me, and a million plus fans that follow me. Come on.
I know it won't be, each one be the same.
Yo, I'm reading from a book where my future's written. It says he came from a humble background to the Billboard charts. Damn, I don't even know how I did it, but I knew that if I worked with the Lord, then I could get it. Everybody telling me that I should go overseas, like money just grows on trees. Like I could just decide to pack my bags and say I'm leaving for America. I'm gonna be a big star, but it's never that simple. Big cars, big cribs, and big chips. It'll happen in good time. I know I'm gonna get it. The crisis, ambitious with big dreams. Whispers and faith flows, I'm gonna kill them. And I know that you think I can't make it on my own, cause you never see God on my side when I walk. Tell him. And if you thought that I was just another dude, think again. This is money in the bank when I rap.
I know. Damn. Yeah.
Dedicated to all my mans. Nah, man. These would have had my back from day one. Everybody on Cairo Road, you know.
One day, each one be the same, baby.
Yo, I remember coming up in a game like back in the day when I was at the crib watching flashy kids. They used to say I was a Dr. Dre wannabe. Now they all wanna be friends, so who's a wannabe now, huh? Holla at your boy, nigga, listen. I've been around, looked around, no competition. This is the passion of the crisis, the hunger for more. Give me a river, cause my thirst never ends. I came from the bottom up, I'm on top of the world now. I'm living handshaking with God. I know you're feeling yourself, you better off just killing yourself. Cause you ain't moving no units on a shelf. I'm a top dog, photographs up in a newspaper. I gotta do an interview, I'll see you later, man.
Mr. Crisis, could you shed some light on your new album?
The album's called Officer in Charge.
Okay, now welcome back to the Rooftop. And we're chilling, we've been seeing the videos. That was Crisis One Day featuring JK. That was like one of the first hip hop songs. That's what put me in the game and say, you know what, I can spit bars, man. After seeing Crisis, I was heavily inspired. So now, this is my favorite part of the show. This is the part I've been waiting for. Like, before we went on the crisis video, I was already like into this part of the show. It's the challenge with King Dizzo. Hey, stick around and find out what King Dizzo got up to. What challenge? Did he get challenged? Or did the challenge challenge him?
Digital wax.
Passport photos. Passport photos.
Wanted everyone to adjust my passport.
Of course.
I don't tell you. Boss, passport photo, boss. Passport photos. Hey, in 25, current 25, black and white 20.
Manje nina chan, nina 15 euro, not for gear and check passport.
But you are going to be a man. 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 Brand. Boy, Robby.
Yeah. Then he
wait.
Okay. Yeah. Sinawa me.
Yeah.
Mike one down. Ah, nice one. Chase up. So T print man. Oh hey, I'm a pass 10 man. Oh naga?
Yeah.
They're using a bunch. Catch the Gazona. Okay,
so Zamba to Sakumanji one by one to Sakumanji.
So I can get a career, man.
Your thing is to
eat or by a man.
Yes, see that fire. Yeah, to Sakumanja.
Killer breathing at Tony, Scazi Jane, honey, DJ Dazzle, Dynamite, Tatino.
I'm short of words, man. King Dizzo.
You imagine.
Know, the challenge, just to explain briefly, is a segment where we challenge, you know, our different public figures, celebrities, you know, to do something that is a bit outside their comfort zone. And yes, we subjected King Dizzo to that challenge. And I don't know, you are the one to tell us how well he performed on the challenge. Like Kachinga said, did he challenge the challenge? Or the challenge challenged him.
So like we were saying earlier, hit us up on Facebook and find out what celebrity do you want to see on the challenge next? And what challenge do you want us to challenge our celebrity? Mm-hmm. So yeah, it's been a great show, Ken One.
It's been a great show.
I've had lots
LSK
of fun.
Coppola combination.
Yo, my brother.
I think we should do this often. What do you think?
Yeah, and we should do one on the Coppola too. Rooftop Coppola edition.
Ah,
you know what I'm saying?
M2, my director, I hope you pick that one up. We need to go to the Copper Belt. All right, unfortunately, you know, we have to go, Kachinga.
Oh, man.
It's been a great show.
Yes, we've had lots and lots of fun.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, all good things come to an end.
Yeah.
When can we catch the repeat?
The repeat, obviously, every, you know, Thursday and Friday at 14:15, you can catch a repeat only on TV2. All right, but for now, we have to go and yes, thank you so much to you, the viewers, for making this production a lovely production. Thank you also to Film Factory M2. Mnyemesha, mnyemesha, I salute you. Remnyodelewe. Are you able to pronounce that?
Remyo Delewe. I learned quick, eh?
We're out of here.
Hi, my name is Munyemesha. Munyemesha, the CEO for Zambian Film Factory. Here at Zambian Film Factory, we do high quality TV adverts, TV documentaries, and TV programs. We also do radio adverts, radio jingles, and radio programs. Besides that, at the Zambian Film Factory, we are also specialized in quality musical videos shot in both 4K and Full HD. At Zambian Film Factory, we also do high quality photos, both for studio based and outside. So you know where to go to when it comes to kitchen parties, weddings, and other events, including the graduation ceremonies, right here at the Zambian Film Factory. Now, time has come for you to make Zambian Film Factory your household name for everything that has to do with picture and sound, and of course, media consultancy. So find us at Findeko House, 15th floor, room 9, along Cairo Road, right here in Lusaka, or give us a call on +26097777744. The Zambian Film Factory, the power to become.
Mukande wanga, when I buy new band, this will get banjot.